Good afternoon, everyone. TMM Gamer here, bringing you part two of my Q&A discussion containing confirmed Modern Warfare 3 information that has been got from Robert Bowling's question and answer session he had a few weeks ago. Well, it's probably about a week ago now. Right, before I get into that, a little word on the gameplay. This is a search and destroy team tactical on radiation, and I am using the FAMAS. Now, the reason I'm using the FAMAS is because this was one of my warm-up games for my 3v3 match that I had. And I was in a party of the with one of the other guys. The other guy hadn't got online yet. But I had to use the FAMAS because that's the weapon I was going to use on the map. So there's no point practicing for a competitive game with something you're not going to use. So it's quite a good score anyway, and I thought it'd be interesting just as a little bit of backing. It won't be long enough to go through all the questions, but if it is a bit short, I'll tack on some Spec Ops gameplay on the end, and so I can continue with the commentary. Right, let's get right into it. The first question of this part is, will there still be a Knife Monkey class along the lines of Modern Warfare 2's Commando Pro, Lightweight Pro, Marathon Pro, Tac Knife sort of class? And 402 replies, absolutely not. We've removed Commando and have rebalanced the knife melee to be in a pinch or unsuspecting full tool that it is meant to be, not a default go-to weapon choice. You should never bring a knife to a gunfight. I think this is an absolutely brilliant thing, because there is nothing more frustrating in Call of Duty than getting taken down by some sap who sits in a corner, hand perched over the knife button, just to mash it whenever he sees someone, because it takes absolutely no skill at all. You know, there's nothing more frustrating in Call of Duty than turning a corner, putting two or three bullets into a guy, and him winning by hammering one button. It's very, very frustrating. It takes no skill, and I'm very, very glad they're taken out of the game. If in a perfect world, I'd make a melee a two-hit kill, unless you stabbed him in the back. But this is second prize, and I'm very, very pleased with it. Right, next question. Could you expand on wave-based modes? Now, there's been a lot of chat about wave-based modes recently, because obviously, zombie mode is in Treyarch's games, and perhaps people have been suggesting that Infinity Ward have simply copied the idea, but this answer is a little bit different to zombie mode, which is, I think, is quite refreshing. And 402 answers, survival mode is Spec Ops, which is playable solo or in co-op, and contains endless waves of increasing more difficult enemies. So this initially sounds just like zombie mode does, but 402 expands a little bit more. First wave is just infantry with standard weapons, then they get better weapons and more accuracy, then it's infantry and dogs, then dogs and infantry, some with C4 strapped to them, then helicopters to shoot down, then juggernauts with riot shields, and even more. It's constantly throwing new tactics and enemies at you. Now that's very, very different to zombie mode, because as you know, zombie mode, at the moment anyway, the new zombies might have something a little bit different, but at the moment they can only club you, they can't actually shoot at you, and they just run towards you in very moronic straight lines. Get into a nice long line, you can mow them all down quite happily. But this sounds like it's a little bit more tactical. The enemies are a little bit more astute, and they can shoot at you. Perhaps they'll throw grenades at you to get you out of your cover. It'll be very, very interesting. But what makes it even more interesting is this next bit of his answer. Now, the cool thing is we have progressive ranking in Spec Ops now, so you'll be able to rank up, unlock new weapons, attachments, gear like turrets, claymores and armor, kill streaks like calling in a squad of Delta to help you defend, or airstrikes so that you can change up your tactics as you rank up. Now, I think this adds a nice dimension to it. It will reward people who put the time into Spec Ops, because last, though, in Modern Warfare 2, it was just a nice little aside that you could do to get the gold stars when you were a little bit fed up on multiplayer, or you played the single player campaign four or five times and you were done with it. But this time, I think, looks like they've put a little bit of extra thought into it, which is only good, because I really, really enjoyed Spec Ops in Modern Warfare 2, and hopefully with these improvements, it'll be even better in Modern Warfare 3. So that's a very, very good thing. Right. The next question is, do you feel like you don't have enough time to work on the games? It seems like Activision just wants to get the game out. Now, this is quite a major criticism of Call of Duty, because obviously with the games coming out every year, people seem to think that perhaps Activision is just wanting to get them out to make money and not actually make the best product they can, because it's very important for such a popular game to have the polish that is wanted by the fans, and perhaps some argue that having a game out every year doesn't really accomplish that. However, 402 goes to dispel that. He says, no, because we've always worked on a two-year development cycle. Our dev time is dictated by us, which is the whole reason Activision started having other developers work on Call of Duty, because we made it clear that we work at the speed we work. We won't rush a product to meet a deadline. We set our dev cycle based around what we know we need. Now, that's a very, very good answer, because if they were a little bit uncertain on that answer, then you could perhaps get the idea that, yes, they did just rush it out for money, but it seems like they do care about their product, despite whatever problems it has, if they do actually care, and that's quite a reassuring answer. Right, the next question is quite a personal one to Infinity Ward, because if you didn't know, just after Modern Warfare 2 was released, perhaps 6 months to a year after, a lot of Infinity Wards left. I think it was because of a lawsuit. I don't really know the details, but a huge proportion of Infinity Wards, probably about 40 to 50%, left to pursue other topics, and that hit Infinity Ward quite hard. And that's one of the reasons why Infinity Ward are having to use Raven Software and Sledgehammer Games to help design Modern Warfare 3, because they don't have the manpower anymore to do what they did with Modern Warfare 2. However, the answer is quite reassuring again. There were many reasons, the main reason being that I wasn't finished working on Modern Warfare. Coming out of Modern Warfare 2, there was a lot of things I wanted to see changed, added and improved on in Modern Warfare 3. With the change-up, I saw the opportunity to step up and attempt to influence that to a greater degree than I had in the past. Now that's quite a good thing, because he said there that he stayed with the project because he believed it was a good thing and he wanted to influence it more. Now that's another good answer. You don't know how genuine he's being on it, but if he is being genuine, then that's a good answer, because it shows that Infinity Ward still do care about their products and about their consumers. Because you could accuse Modern Warfare 2 of just being a little bit of a flashy gimmick with a lot of noobish perks and ideas and design to catch a casual gamer and to piss off the gamer who actually made Call of Duty what it was during COD 4. But it looks anyway that is a good answer anyway. It looks that they do care about their products, and hopefully we'll see that in Modern Warfare 3. Right. The final question, and one that's quite important for me, because obviously I upload videos to YouTube and I wouldn't be able to do it without Black Ops Theatre Mode, is, will there be something similar to Black Ops Theatre Mode for multiplayer? And 402 answers, yes, but the exact implementation of it is not finished. It is important to look at features and make sure they are optimised in a way that does not affect frame rate or gameplay for the sake of just having it. Now, I seriously do hope they have a theatre mode in Black Ops, because at the moment my capture card can't capture in HD. So what I do is I play the game in HD, save it to my theatre mode, then go into the standard definition and record it onto my computer with standard definition. I did try and play a few games just using the standard definition, but unfortunately my TV is not brilliant, so it can't really define enemies clearly enough. So I have to play in HD so I can get the beast gameplay that I know everyone on YouTube expects, and then I record it in standard definition and get it up online. So it would be brilliant for me personally if there was a theatre mode on Black Ops, and it'd be brilliant for the community at large, because they'd be able to show off their best kills. It's a much better thing to have a theatre mode in a game like Call of Duty than it is not to have it. For example, a game like Brink was a game that has absolutely stunning visuals, but they didn't bother to put a theatre mode in it, and I think that was a massive opportunity missed on their part, because that game can look so brilliant and the theatre mode would have really blown people's minds with the visuals. But unfortunately they thought that they couldn't get it in the game, and that was very disappointing. But I sincerely hope Modern Warfare 3 does have that option to get a theatre mode in it. Right, that's the main part of the question, and that's all the questions that I thought were the most interesting. What I'm going to do is I'm going to leave a link in the description to the full questionnaire, so if you guys wanted to check it out yourself or wanted to see the questions that perhaps I've just glossed over, then you'll be able to do that. But I have to say my opinion of Call of Duty has vastly improved after seeing that questionnaire, because at E3 it seemed a lot of the same things that Modern Warfare 2 was. Very, very nice visuals, very good campaign, but a deeply flawed multiplayer in my opinion. But it does look like Infinity Ward are learning their lessons from Modern Warfare 2 and will get out a game which is brilliant, because I think all of us want a game that is pretty as close to flawless as you can get it, because obviously Battlefield 3 looks incredible at E3 and it promises to be probably really strongly competing with Modern Warfare 3 for the game of the year. So I sincerely hope that Modern Warfare 3 does pull out all the stops and get a game that we can all enjoy, and the signs with that questionnaire show that it can. Right, just a little bit on what I'm planning for this week before I get onto it. I have some very nice HS10 gameplay that I'm going to bring you. Got some nice foul gameplay, so I'm going to continue my series Fed Up of the FAMAS. I'm going on holiday in about a week and a half, so there'll be about 7 days where I won't put a video up. I might put a put a video onto the scheduled uploader on YouTube, but I think that's quite buggy at the moment, so I'm not sure about that yet. But what I'm planning is after the holiday, if I've got enough money left, I will get a HD capture card. Now, I just need to ask a question of people. Does the HD PVR that Hoporge do, is it Hoporge? Not sure if I pronounced that right, but they do a HD PVR. Will that work with a PS3? Because I've had a couple of people saying it won't and a couple of people saying it will. So it'd be great to know if that does work with the PS3, because if it does, that'll be the one I'm going to get, because it does very, very good picture, crystal clear, and I think it's only, you know, a thing that my channel will need to get forward, because I've got a good mic now and it's just that HD quality picture that's holding me back a little bit. So hopefully I'll get that in pretty soon after I've got back from holiday, and then I'll continue to do videos like these giving you information on Modern Warfare 3 and hopefully getting your interest up for the game and getting your interest up for Battlefield. Right, I hope you enjoyed the commentary, guys. I'm going to cut it off there. Once again, thanks for watching. If you did enjoy the video, please leave a rating. And even if you didn't enjoy the video, please leave a rating. Show me that you're awake, because I'm doing this channel to interact with people out there. And it's brilliant. Even if you don't like the video, I really want you to say why, to, you know, to leave a dislike, and perhaps I'll try something different. There's nothing more frustrating for me than seeing a video get quite a lot of views and very little feedback in any sort of way. But if you could just, you know, click a button, leave a comment, that'd be really, really helpful to me, guys. And leave a comment on what you think about Robert Boland's Q&A. It was quite an in-depth Q&A, covered a lot of areas, and I really want to know what you think about it. And then perhaps we could get a good discussion going on the comments about areas that perhaps you weren't quite sure about in the Q&A and areas that you really were happy about. But anyway, I'm cut it off there, guys. Once again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.